Hi everyone, Kevin here. Today, we are going to look at how you can use Bing Chat. Bing Chat is amazing technology that's kind of like having your own personal assistant next to you all the time. With Bing Chat, you can have conversations. You can generate images. You can extract text from images as just a few examples. And we'll look at all of the different ways that you can use it. Bing Chat uses OpenAI's GPT-4 together with a Microsoft technology called Prometheus, which gives you up-to-date information. And the amazing thing is all of this is completely free to use. Let's check this out. To get Bing Chat, navigate to the following website, and then you get a full screen experience where you can interact with the AI. This works on any operating system as well as with any browser. However, that said, if you use Microsoft Edge, you get longer conversations. You can also use Bing Chat directly in the Edge web browser. In the top right-hand corner, click on the Bing logo, and then it opens up a pane where you can interact with the AI. You can also use Edge on your phone, and this also gives you access to the AI. If you're using the latest version of Windows 11, down on the taskbar, you can click on the Copilot icon, and this also opens up a pane over on the right-hand side, and that gives you access to Bing Chat. My preferred way of interacting with the AI is to use the Edge browser and also to sign in using a Microsoft account. When you do that, you can have the longest possible conversations with the AI, and it also saves a history of all of your conversations. Let's now check out some of the ways that you can use Bing Chat. Here I am on the Bing Chat homepage, and I personally like using it in the web browser the best because you get the entire screen real estate to interact with the AI. At the very top of the page, you'll see various examples of how you can engage with the AI, so you can look through those. As we scroll down a little bit on the page, we can choose a conversation style, and you have three different options. You have creative, balanced, and also precise. When you hover over, you'll see a description of how the different modes differ. However, you can also just experiment to see which one you like. From what I've seen, creative works very well when, say, you want to compose a new email message, or maybe you want to brainstorm some new ideas. Over here with precise, I found that the answers tend to be much more concise and you get accurate information. And then over here, balanced sits in between these two different options. One thing to note, as you click on these different modes, you'll notice that the background color changes and also the button color changes down here, just as a reminder which mode you're currently in. For this, let's click into the creative mode. To have a conversation with the AI, down at the very bottom, we have a text field where you can ask anything, and you truly can ask anything in, and you'll get a response. You could type in your question, or over on the right-hand side, you can also use the microphone if you'd prefer to speak your question. I'd like to pull together a grocery shopping list to make chocolate chip cookies, and let's see if the AI can help with this. One thing to note, down at the very bottom, you can type in up to 4,000 characters, and you'd be surprised at how quickly you can use those up. Once you type in your question, you can press enter, or you can click on the submit button in the bottom right-hand corner. Let's see what the AI comes back with. And check that out. Right up above, I have the list of all of the different ingredients that I need to buy, along with the associated quantity. The really nice thing about this experience is I don't have to dig through all these different websites to find the ingredients and the quantities. Instead, I just ask my question and here I get my response. I think that's so much quicker. One of the nice things is down at the very bottom, I can also see the sources for this information, so I could always navigate back to the source website. Looking up above at this information, it's currently formatted in a bulleted list, but I can also refine these results. So down below in the text field, what if I say, can you show this as a table? And let's see if the AI can modify this. Right up above, I now have a table that tells me all the different ingredients and the different amounts. Down below in the bottom right-hand corner, we see this message that says 2 of 30. When I interact with the AI, I can ask up to 30 different questions as part of this conversation, and the AI will keep the context of what we're talking about. Down below, let me ask one more question. I'll say, how do I bake them? Well, what is them? Well, it knows that we're talking about chocolate chip cookies, so it should give me back the baking instructions for chocolate chip cookies. Let's see what it comes back with. And look at this. Over on the side, I now get baking instructions back. And again, it remembers the context of that conversation. Here it gives me baking instructions for chocolate chip cookies. And here I have all of the instructions. I can ask up to 27 more questions as part of this conversation, but I think for now I have what I need. When I hover over one of the responses, I get these different actions that I could take. Here, I could like the message or I could dislike the message. And this helps train Bing's AI to give better results in the future. Over here, I could also copy the results. And here, if I click on export, you have a number of different options for exporting what the AI returned back. Over here, I could also share it, and I could also continue on the phone by scanning in this QR code. So I have a number of different options. I think I now have everything that I need to be able to bake these chocolate chip cookies, and I'm ready to move on to a new topic. In the bottom left-hand corner, I can click on this new topic button, and that'll reset the context, and it'll also reset the number of questions that I can ask the AI. So for every conversation, you can ask up to 30 questions. Let's click on new topic. This now gives me a clean slate to work with. At the Kevin Cookie Company, my manager has asked me to design 3 new t-shirts for the Kevin Cookie Company. So what should I do? Well, of course, let's use AI to help with this. I run a cookie company called the Kevin Cookie Company. Can you come up with 3 t-shirt ideas? And let's see what the AI comes back with. And look at that. Here I have 3 different ideas. Because this is a conversation, I could always go back to the AI and I could ask it to give me even more ideas. But I think for now, I can work with these 3. One of the really neat things about Bing Chat is they recently integrated with OpenAI's DALL-E 3. So what is that? Well, you can type in a text prompt and it'll generate an image from that prompt. So down below, let's ask, can you create some visuals for these ideas? And let's see what it comes back with. Wow, and look at this. Here I get all of these different designs based on those different ideas. So AI came up with the ideas, and then AI also came up with different designs for t-shirts, and it placed it on a t-shirt with the text. This is incredible. Here, if I go down, we see all these different beautiful designs. Now, one of the really neat things too is here I can click on one of these designs, and this opens up Bing's image creator. Here, I see the t-shirt design, and it also shows me the original prompt that the Bing image creator used, a t-shirt with the slogan, "Keep calm and eat Kevin's cookies," in a large font, and a small logo of your company on the chest. So look at that. Here you can see the exact text that it used to generate this image. This is so impressive. Back now within Bing Chat, let's test some other examples. Let's see if maybe it could design a logo for the Kevin Cookie Company, and let's see what it comes up with. And look at that. Here I get some different options for logos for the Kevin Cookie Company. And of course the text isn't all correct. Here it's missing an I. It doesn't say company, but it gives me a good starting point. I could take any one of these now and I can continue to refine and modify it. Now, one thing I would like to refine is we use the colors blue and yellow for the Kevin Cookie Company. So let me follow up and say, can you use the colors blue and yellow? And let's make it 3D. Let's make it look really cool. Let's try again. Wow, and here too, I have another set of logos that I could choose from. And maybe this one could be our mascot. Now, the great thing is I could keep refining this until I get exactly what I want. Like, let's add a glass of milk to this and let's see what it comes back with. Right up above, I now have a number of different sample images of the Kevin Cookie Company logo that incorporate a glass of milk. I like this one right here. That looks pretty cool. I can go back and I can continue refining until I get exactly what I want. Not only can you use Bing Chat to generate an image, but you can also use it to analyze an existing image. So what do I mean by that? Well, in the bottom left-hand corner, let's click on new topic to give us a clean slate. Down at the bottom of the text prompt, I have this icon. And when I click on this, I can paste in an image or a link of an image. I could also upload an image from my device, or I could even take a picture. But what's even easier, here I have an image on my desktop of chocolate chip cookies. I could simply drag and drop that into this text box and I could place it right there. Here it's uploaded my image and I can now ask a question alongside that image. For example, let's say I didn't know this was a chocolate chip cookie. I could say, what type of cookie is this? And let's see if the AI knows. And look at that. It has correctly identified that this picture is a chocolate chip cookie. Not only does it identify what type of cookie it is, but it also gives me all sorts of information about chocolate chip cookies. That is really impressive, and I could see us using this at the Kevin Cookie Company to identify what types of cookies our competitors are making. Let's go back now and let's try uploading another image. Here I have one of our recipes here at the Kevin Cookie Company for Clippy's Scrumptious Cookie. I'll take the recipe and here I'll upload that. Here, I could also ask questions about it. Like, let's extract the text from this image. Let's see if it could do that. Here, let's send it through. And right up above here, I can now see my image with Clippy's scrumptious cookie recipe. It's just an image file. And here it's extracted the text from that image, all of the text and also all of the directions. Right up here, I could also copy this text and I can now use this anywhere. This is so impressive. In the bottom left-hand corner, let's click on new topic one more time. With Bing Chat, you can also direct it to other websites to analyze the content on those websites. Let's see if it could summarize this website. It's one of my favorite websites, thekevincookiecompany.com. Let's see what it comes back with. And here it's produced a summary of the Kevin Cookie Company website, and all this information is right on point. As we've been going through this, you might have noticed over on the right-hand side, we have a history of all of the different conversations that we've had with the AI. Let's say I want to go back to look at that grocery list for chocolate chip cookies. I can click on this, and that brings me back to that conversation that I had with the AI. And at the very bottom, if I haven't used up my 30 questions yet, I can continue this conversation. Over in the history, I could click on this pencil icon and I could rename this conversation with the AI. That way it's easier to get back to the conversations that I care about. I'll stick with this name. Over here, you could also click on the ellipsis and you have a few different options to export or share these conversations. All right, well, that was a quick look at how you can use Bing Chat by your very favorite AI, Kevin. Now, one word of caution before you start proceeding and using this, it's always very important to check your work. Sometimes there may be surprises and also the occasional mistake. To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing and I hope to see you in the next video.